The creed of the Assassin Brotherhood teaches us that nothing is forbidden to us. Once, I thought that meant we were free to do as we would, to pursue our ideals no matter the cost. I understand now. Not a grant of permission, the creed is a warning. Ideals too easily give way to dogma. Dogma becomes fanaticism. No higher power sits in judgment of us. No supreme being watches to punish us for our sins. In the end, only we ourselves can guard against our obsessions. Only we can decide whether the road we walk carries too high a toll. We believe ourselves redeemers, avengers, saviors. We make war on those who oppose us, and they in turn make war on us. We dream of leaving our stamp upon the world. Even as we give our lives in a conflict that will be recorded in no history book, all that we do, all that we are, begins and ends with ourselves.
You know, that actually seems like a really good ending for the series in general. Huh. Oh, Arno's back. Interesting ending. But no, that ending before, you know, it said years later.
My God, I don't believe what I'm seeing. Arno won this fight 2 centuries before it started. Well done, kid. I don't think Abstergo will bother searching the catacombs for Germain's body. The bones are going to be too damaged, too decayed. We're in the clear with this, Sage. You did good work, Initiate. Until we contact you again, the best you can do is continue searching Arno's memories for anything else he might have seen, like rare historical data, more DNA samples, anything to help our cause. We'll be in touch when we need you. Count on it.
All right. So, here is my review for Assassin's Creed Unity. First and foremost, this game was way better than fucking Rogue. It was way better. And, you know, if you want to know why I say that, you know, one, just watch my review for Rogue, my finale / review. Rogue just felt like a, it just felt, ugh. I hate thinking about that game. I didn't even want to play that game again just to, you know, get every single recording. I just did not like that game at all. So, with that being said, Assassin's Creed Unity, it is not a perfect game. It is definitely a game with faults. Granted, I am lucky to say that I did not experience any game bugs. You know, because everyone was saying this was one of the worst, buggiest games out there, and I did not experience, okay, I experienced like one or two of them, but they weren't game breaking, so I am lucky on that. And so for that, I will say, I will not take a point off, so I'm glad about that. I am very happy I did not deal with a bug or a glitch. Secondly, the story. It's not rememberable. I will say that. It's not anything that will get you wanting to play the game more for the story, because the story is a little forgettable. I actually took a lot of breaks from this game, and thinking about it, I just didn't care too much about the story to even jump into the game. But I will say the story did get interesting in the last couple sequences, because there was a little bit more tension, it was a little bit more high stakes, and the romance was definitely the stronger point of this game. Arno, I have to say, was an okay character. Didn't hate him. A lot of people did hate him, but I didn't hate him at all. I thought he was okay at best. He's a good character, but he's not one of my favorites. My favorite is still Ezio and Altair, and then it goes to maybe Edward, Connor. No, wait. It'd be Ezio, Altair, Arno, I would say, or Arno and Edward, Connor, and then Shay, because Shay was a shit fucking character. But yeah, I liked him. I didn't hate him. I didn't love him, but I liked him. I wish he had a little bit more to him than just, dealing with the whole love story. Gameplay-wise, I said this before and I'll say it again. A lot of people said Black Flags and Rogue was like a very good step in the right direction for the Assassin's Creed series. And for that, I say I completely disagree, because all it was adding new gameplay features. And well, Rogue really wasn't. Rogue was just a basic copy of Black Flags, but it was not a step in the right direction. It was just adding more gameplay features, which made it more into a different type of genre game. Because I've always said, Assassin's Creed Black Flag, it's a great pirates game, but a very bad Assassin's Creed game, because how they added all those features to the game, it just felt like it was a completely different genre or a different title, but with the Assassin's Creed logo and some gameplay features added onto it. So that being said, how people said that about those games, this, I have to say, is the step in the right direction in terms of gameplay, because the gameplay, it was vastly improved, and I was very impressed by it. I loved every second of the gameplay. Okay, that's a lie. I didn't love every second of the gameplay. There were some points where I actually wanted to throw the controller across the room, because sometimes the gameplay doesn't make sense. Gameplay mechanics also don't make sense. And the fact, well, I don't want to say gameplay mechanics or just gameplay in general, because it does play well. I love the parkour. I love the combat. I think the combat was a lot better, and someone actually said it was easier. I'm not gonna say who, but someone actually said the combat was a lot easier than in other games. I completely disagree, because the combat was way too easy in the other games, to where once you kill somebody, and you can do a chain attack and actually execute every single other person in the area. And that was easy. This was a lot more difficult, and I liked that. I liked that added difficulty. Though then again, it's a little too difficult. I will say that it was a little too difficult. So for that, I can't say a negative, but at the same time I want to, because the fact that a lot of them just pull out guns out of nowhere. Well, not out of nowhere, but they pull out guns almost all the time and shoot you, and the guns take out a lot of your life. And the fact that that Ubisoft made the game more realistic, because the parkour is very realistic in the movements now. But also, enemies can spot you in places that other Assassin's Creed games you would never get spotted in. When you're in a hay barrel, you're trying to kill somebody, it would no one would ever notice. But with this one, if it's in the corner of their eye, they'll notice. If your head's just popping out a little bit, they'll see it. It's very realistic, but it's annoying as hell, because I guess it's more like you have to kind of play it again a little bit more just to get used to the feeling of it being realistic. Because, like I said, in the other Assassin's Creed games, it wasn't like that. It was a little bit more. It was, I want to say easier, but it wasn't too easy. You know, I'm trying to find the right word, but I can't. I will say though, I'm very disappointed in the fact that this game is connected into Assassin's Creed Rogue. Not saying that because I hated Rogue, but because it had very little to do with Assassin's Creed Rogue. It was just the introduction, and I was really hoping Shay Cormac would actually end up somewhere in the game. You know, Arno fights him, gets revenge for his father, and you know, I was hoping for something like that, but there wasn't anything about that. I actually was very disappointed in that. I was actually really looking forward to killing Shay Cormac because I hated the character. So, but besides that, I'm actually legitimately disappointed, besides the fact of wanting to kill Shay. It was, you know, they kind of made, I don't know if they really made a big deal about, you know, Unity and Rogue being connected, but if they did, I'd be very disappointed because there was very little to be even interested in when it comes to the connection. I am disappointed though that there wasn't much present day story, but then again, after Assassin's Creed Rogue and Black Flags, I can give less than two shits about a present day story. But then again, you were with the Assassins, and hopefully the Assassins don't have Assassin's Entertainment where it's just like Ubisoft, because that is a smart idea. Fucking stupid. I'm sorry, Abstergo Entertainment is the stupidest idea ever. So with that being said, because I'm pretty sure I'm getting close to 15 minutes, I would give this game an 8 out of 10. The gameplay I highly enjoyed. There are some moments where you just want to freaking strangle somebody in terms of how difficult the game can get. Story, it's not that interesting, but while the main character is okay, in my opinion, and you know, the love story is the strongest point. All I can really say is it really is an 8 out of 10 for me. I really enjoyed it. It's the first Assassin's Creed game I really enjoyed thoroughly. I mean, like I said, I enjoyed Black Flags, but for the most part, you know, because it just didn't feel like an Assassin's Creed game, I just can't love it or like it. It's just okay in my book. It's okay in my book now that I played Rogue, because Rogue was complete garbage, and I like Assassin's Creed Black Flags a little bit more. But anyways, this is the first Assassin's Creed game I gotta say I liked a lot since Assassin's Creed 3, because Assassin's Creed 3 I actually really did enjoy. And yeah, not much to say. So I hope you guys enjoyed the Let's Play, and I hope you guys liked the review. If you didn't, and you think I'm a complete moron for even liking this game, because some people actually really hate this game, sorry, but that's my opinion. And we are all entitled to our own opinions. Go suck a fat one. Anyways, that is my review, and I will see you guys again next time on the next Assassin's Creed game coming next year, because we all know Ubisoft loves to milk this series. It's starting to hurt becoming an Assassin's Creed fan.